We're already set up for our second to last speaker, guys, who's going to talk about immutability and upgradeability, security versus security. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Toghrul Maharramov.
Hello, everyone. My name is Toghrul. I do research at Scroll. And today I'm going to talk about immutability and upgradeability within rollups and how both are just different dimensions of security. So, fuel v1, decade, what do they have in common? The same applies here. What does Arbitrum, Optimism, Polygon, Scroll, StarkNet, ZK Sync, and many, many others have in common? So in the case of the former, it's the fact that they're both immutable. And in the case of the latter, they're upgradable. But both of them do that for sake of security, but they are just different approaches to security. So first, let's talk about what a rollup is in the context of upgradeability. So a rollup is required to have a 28-day upgrade delay, and that is relevant to the bridge. And terms and conditions apply, meaning that we don't really have a universal definition for that. Vitalik, for example, uses 30 days. Some people say that you can have a security council to upgrade instantly, etc. But I'll talk about that later. But let's assume that this is the concrete definition for now. So we have a rollup. We have a base layer. So in the case of all the rollups that I listed before, that's going to be Ethereum. And we have a validating bridge that is deployed on top of the base layer. And we use that bridge to facilitate communication between the base layer and the rollup. And so let's say we have the first version of the rollup, bridge v1, et cetera, et cetera. But something went wrong, or we want to add a new feature, and our bridge is immutable. What do we do then? Well, we just deploy a new bridge, instantiate a new rollup, and that's it. So, and let the people deal with migrations, et cetera, et cetera. Now, let's go with an example of an upgradable bridge. So, you have the same scenario, bridge v1, rollup, but the bridge is upgradable in this case. You take the base layer again, deploy the second version of the bridge, and now you just communicate with the second version of the bridge. So, there's no migration involved. Unfortunately, both of these approaches have their own downsides and upsides. So, what are the upsides of immutability? So, one of the upsides is the fact that there are no synchrony assumptions. I'll explain what that is in this context later. And there are also no complex exit strategies. And the protocol is rogue resistant. But unfortunately, it comes with a significant con. Actually, two of them. So one is you can't patch vulnerabilities. So for example, if you find a bug in the bridge or the protocol, that's it. You're stuck with it. Like, there's nothing you can do. The only thing that you can do is warn users to exit as fast as possible. And there are no state migration strategies in case there is a protocol upgrade. So for example, I want to add some new cool feature to my rollup, and I need to upgrade the bridge for that. What do I do in this case? Nothing really, I can't really do anything. I'll just deploy a new instance and hope that the users and the application operators migrate to my new version. And upgradeability. Upgradeability has its own pros, and it's basically the inverse. We are able to patch vulnerabilities. So let's say there's a bug, I can instantly upgrade the contract and make sure that the attacker doesn't get to it before I upgrade. And the same is true with a protocol upgrade. So essentially, I can just upgrade the bridge and let the users have the latest features without having them do any work. But again, unfortunately, it comes with the cons. So there's synchrony assumption. So let's say there's the upgradeability is delayed. So there's as I said before, there is a 28-day delay. So the users have only 28 days to exit in case of a malicious upgrade. So let's say my upgradeability key got hacked and I initiated the upgrade in a way where I can steal money from you once the upgrade is finalized. So the users become aware of that, but they only have 28 days to exit. And basically, let's say if you're out on an island on a holiday and you come back after 2 months, that's it. Your money may be gone. And two, there are, the exit strategies are very complex. So let's say if there are a lot of users on a rollup and there's a malicious upgrade and you know that you need to exit within those 28 days, the problem here is that there might not be enough capacity on Ethereum to allow you to exit without paying an exorbitant amount of fees. And therefore, we essentially get the same problem that we had with Plasma, which is that there's an exit problem, a mass exit problem here, where the people trying to exit to the L1 can just overwhelm the entire system. And no rug resistance. But again, as before, terms and conditions apply. So in this case, what I mean by rug resistance is that you can replace the contract with a malicious construct and instantly deploy it. So let's say if there's a delay, this is not applicable. But in some cases, as I'll explain later, that might be applicable. So, and one more note. So for ZK EVMs, for example, immutability is not an option. And once again, terms and conditions apply here. So, and the reason why they apply is because, let's say if EVM ossifies tomorrow, then it's perfectly fine to have an immutable ZK EVM. But since the goal of ZK EVM is to retain compatibility with EVM, there is, we always want to make sure that we are able to upgrade the ZK EVM in case EVM gets upgraded, to make sure that we always retain that compatibility. And therefore, we need to have a certain upgradeability path. And so what is the current state of the art approach? So let's say you're a ZK EVM that needs upgradeability. You would have some form of a delayed upgrade, let's say 28 days, with an external security council that can essentially short-circuit that delay and bypass it and allow you to upgrade instantly. So what is a security council? The security council is typically a set of external entities between 12 and 15 who are responsible for, who have the capability of initiating, fast-tracking the upgrade. So again, I initiate the upgrade, the delay is initiated, but then the quorum signs and the delay is either shortcut or completely removed, and the upgrade is handled straight away. Sorry. So that's how it will work. So let's say the delayed upgrade is initiated by a 3 out of 5 multisig, team multisig. You initiate a 28-day delayed upgrade, but there's a bug, so you don't want to wait for 28 days. The reason why you're upgrading is because there's a bug. So there comes the 9 out of 12 Security Council multisig. So if the quorum is reached there, they can just sign, send the signature, the quorum signature to the bridge and bypass the delay. And the main reason for that is to allow us to have an instant upgrade in case there's a severe bug that may potentially result in funds being drained, but it also allows us to not have internal control of instant upgradeability, so we outsource it to some trusted third parties. So for example, L2B would be a good example of a trusted party. But as I said, there are cons to this, as unfortunately with everything in life. One is coordination complexity. So let's say if you handle the upgradeability internally, it's much more easier to coordinate with people. And let's say if there's an emergency where you need to upgrade as soon as possible, it's much easier to get hold of parties that are internal to the team. Whereas when it comes to external parties, it might be problematic or even impossible to reach them at a certain point. And two, there's a risk of potential complacency. So what I mean by complacency in this case is, let's say I just sign every upgrade without checking it. So the reason why you need the Security Council is that so they can check that the upgrade is actually valid. But if nobody checks, they can just trust that the team is being honest and sign it without checking anything. And in that case, it just adds an unnecessary step. It doesn't benefit anything in terms of security. So an alternative approach to using some form of upgradeability would be enshrinement of the validating bridge. And what I mean by that is enshrining, we basically make the bridge part of the base layer protocol. So in case of Ethereum, an example would be Optimism bridge would be part of Ethereum protocol rather than the smart contract deployed on top of it. And basically, it enables us to have the social consensus of the base layer handle the validating bridge upgrades. So the way you would upgrade Ethereum, so add certain features, so for example, recently we added push zero as an opcode, you would do the same with the bridge. You would just, it would just come in one package and some form of a precompile probably or something like that, and that will be just changed in the execution client, and that's it. But unfortunately, again, there are downsides here. So one, it negatively affects the base layer's credible neutrality. And so what I mean by that is, let's say in case of Ethereum, there are probably 20 different rollups and of different types, etc. And Ethereum is unlikely to support all of them, to enshrine all of them. So they would have to pick the winner or pick a couple of winners. And therefore, those winners get the preferential treatment over everybody else. And that affects how neutral Ethereum acts towards protocols being built on top of it. And two, it increases the burden of coordination for the base layer social consensus, because now you don't only have to take care of the EVM features, consensus, etc. You also have to take care of the features of the bridge. You need to coordinate between more teams, and that results in slower upgrade times, et cetera, and make certain things even more difficult than they are right now. But there are more cons. So it also increases the base layer upgrade complexity. So as I said before, because you need to coordinate much more, and also because it adds complexity to the base layer, the difference here is that, let's say if the enshrined bridge fails, then the base layer protocol fails. If the bridge that is deployed at the contract fails, Ethereum still works as intended. It doesn't really affect Ethereum per se. And therefore, you need to make sure that the upgrade is secure. And it might take longer time to audit, to look at different parts, etc., because rollup bridges are quite complex. And because of what I described before, it incentivizes homogeneous validating bridge design. So what I mean by that is it incentivizes the base layer to have only one type of bridge. So for example, Optimism or StarkNet or some other type. Because of the complexities involved, you would rather just deal with one than have three, four, five, whatever, and deal with them separately, which will slow down the upgrade path even more and make the social consensus even more complex to handle. And what is the perfect solution then? Well, again, unfortunately, there are no perfect solutions. And every single solution that I have outlined, unfortunately, has certain trade-offs in terms of security. And one thing that you should remember is that because rollups are not mature enough right now, there are still a lot of things that are yet to be discovered or implemented or even thought of, and therefore the state of the rollups right now might not be reflective of where the rollups are going to be in the next 2 years. It might be the case that in 1 year this problem is completely solved and it was just a nothing burger that nobody should have thought about. So thank you for your attention, and if you have any questions, feel free to ask them.
Thank you for the talk. I really enjoyed it. I have a question. What is Scroll?
Scroll is a ZKVM-based rollup on top of Ethereum, specifically where a type 2 rollup, ZKVM from Vitalik's gradation of rollups. So we are bytecode equivalent, but we are not Ethereum equivalent, meaning that you are able to prove the computation of EVM completely, but you're unable to prove Ethereum blocks within RZKVM.
Everybody!